In this video, we'll show you some common drying monitor temperature probe responses and how they help you understand what's going on inside your drying hopper. Note that the descriptions and curve examples shown in this presentation are for general reference only. Common variables, like these shown here, will affect how a specific drying system's trending curves and temperature data will actually be displayed. To maximize the usefulness of the drying monitor's temperature readings, Conair recommends that users familiarize themselves with the common patterns explained in this video and in your manual as an aid to monitoring your drying system. As an overview, here is a listing of the temperature probes in your drying hopper and their approximate locations. T1 is located on the bottom, near the hot air inlet, and T6 is near the top of the hopper. We'll use these references and colors throughout this presentation. First, the drying monitor can be used to determine when successful resin drying is underway and processing can begin, using two simple steps. Step 1. The alarm location sensor for your drying system should be selected according to the drying monitor's instructions. It is usually hopper sensor T3 or T4. Step 2. Reading the temperature of this alarm location sensor can determine when the hopper's material has been sufficiently heated for the proper residence time and processing of that material can begin. The guideline is, processing can begin when the alarm location sensor stabilizes at the drying temperature set point for approximately 50% of the required residence time. Example, if the material drying temperature is 250 degrees and the required residence time is 4 hours, once the alarm location sensor has displayed 250 degrees for 2 hours, or 50% of 4 hours, processing can begin. Now, if the alarm location sensor never reaches the drying temperature set point, this will be your first indication that there is a problem with your drying system and it should be examined for proper operation before proceeding. Here are some additional patterns you can observe to confirm the success of your drying system's operation. Upon startup with a full hopper of material, temperatures read by all 6 drying monitor probes will naturally rise towards the drying set point temperature, starting with the lowest sensor, T1. Now, if processing does not start, that is, no material is taken away from the hopper, eventually all the probes will come very close to this process temperature, with the possible exception of the very top one, T6, if it is located above the material level. We'll discuss T6 a bit more in a moment. In normal operation, with material flowing through the hopper, sensor T1 will read closest to the process air temperature, and T2 and T3 will typically be very close to the process air temperature as well. T4 and T5 will display temperatures descending in value from the process temperature. T6 will also follow this pattern unless it is located above the material, which is very common. Note that T6, located in the airspace at the top of the hopper, will commonly display a temperature higher than T5, which is located in the material. This is because a sensor in the open air is not in contact with heat-consuming resin. This is especially true at higher drying temperatures, like 270 degrees F and higher. Common reasons for T6 to be located in the airspace at the top of the hopper can be hopper design, and how the material flows in and comes to rest in the hopper, called the angle of repose. The loading system can also determine the size of the no material area at the top of the hopper, depending upon where the demand switch for loading more material is located, and how far into the hopper the discharge of the loader or receiver extends. One additional note on material levels. Hoppers being used at less than full capacity, that is, using lowered demand sensors, are very likely to have more than one drying monitor sensor exposed to air and not covered by the material being dried. This should be taken into consideration when viewing your drying monitor data, since these open sensors will typically show higher temperatures. As a helpful pattern to confirm consistent resin loading, the drying monitor can show material loading as a decrease in the T5 temperature as new colder material is loaded, alternating with a rise of T5 as that new material absorbs drying heat. This reaction will be seen as a familiar sawtooth up and down temperature pattern. If material flow through the drying hopper is slowed down, the difference in temperature readings between T1 and T5 will steadily decrease. T4 and T5 will gradually rise towards the T1 temperature since the slower moving material will absorb more of the drying heat. If material flow through the hopper is stopped, the temperature readings from T4, T5, and T6 will begin to increase and align with the process temperature. The stopped material now has time to more fully absorb drying heat, and upper sensors will indicate this condition. If the material flow rate increases, the difference in temperature readings between T1 through T5 will steadily increase. The faster moving material now spends less time being heated, so the difference in temperatures read at the bottom of the hopper compared to the top will display a greater spread. This can also be the result of an increase in the proportion of regrind material being dried. Increasing the quantity of regrind decreases the bulk density of the material being dried and increases the flow of material. If the loading function stops and no new material is being supplied to the hopper while normal operation is underway, T5 and T6 will increase in temperature. This is because that as the heat-consuming material level in the hopper decreases, the upper sensors are exposed to the hot air of the hopper. T4 will eventually follow, especially if it also becomes exposed to air and not material. Note: successful drying is in jeopardy if the supply of material to the hopper is interrupted. Even if the problem is corrected and the hopper is refilled, this new material will not have the proper residence time for successful drying. An interesting, readily identifiable pattern occurs when loading is restored and new material is once again supplied to the hopper. T5 and T6 will initially drop in temperature from exposure to the new, colder material coming into the hopper. This initial drop can be compared to a cold front of material moving down through the hopper that has not had full exposure to drying. These temperatures will eventually rise and realign into a normal temperature profile as drying stabilizes, but halting of the process should be considered to prevent the production of insufficiently dried product. After a material shortage, the drying system needs to catch up and deliver proper residence time to the new material. Problems with the supply of heat to the drying hopper initially show up as a reduction in T1 and T2 temperature readings. But this reduction may not display immediately due to the residual heat of the material. The sensors above T1 and T2 probes will also sequentially decrease in temperature as the problem continues. Problems with the air supply to the drying hopper, like a clogged filter or blocked dry air supply line, initially show up as a reduction in the T5, T4, and eventually the T3 temperature readings, because airflow is no longer strong enough to carry the drying heat up through the hopper. This can be a very gradual change as filters gradually become clogged. But T1 and T2 will continue to display levels close to the process temperature as long as the heat supply is still operating correctly. Additional tips on understanding what the valuable drying monitor is telling you can be found in your drying monitor manual, along with instructions on how to analyze, trend, and export hopper temperature data for detailed tracking of every minute of your drying operation.